Hi, I'm Jim.
Hey.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
She's on the longest plane ride in the world.
They went to China first, I think.
Sorry, keep you waiting so long. 11 minutes away from the end.
Well, he's in and he's not allowed to have any business.
He can after, I'll let you know that. I think it's the first week he detox, so it's a blackout, that's just a good medical treatment. And once he's in the next phase, I think it's a good workout day. It's a long worry.
You see, Charlie, he can't.
Sorry. I keep hitting the door.
I figured as much as I can get a text.
He was supposed to smile on me after the play, but I was so bad by that. It was
to send another crew from New York. It was crazy.
Remember that? Remember that flight where they fell asleep in the plane and they overshot out west? They overshot the airport. They got lost for 3 hours. Well, they worked them too.
Yeah, that was
the
thing. They had to barrel through people to get into that room. Well, I flew Russia. It was 12 hours.
We went to Australia.
That was
a fun one.
That's another one, yeah.
Oh, my gosh. She was bad to the rich.
I was looking at Australia last night on National Geographic. It's unbelievable.
That's, if you could ever go, that's the best place to go. It's so awesome.
New Zealand, too.
I'm from Staten Island.
What
I was told is on a lot of TV shows. And well, actually, what happened? America's Dumbest Criminals, Dumbest Stunts, True TV, I'm on that probably every week. I'm on, I was on Don't Forget the Lyrics, I won 200,000 singing to Wayne Brady.
Really? Cool.
I think that's
like one of our favorite shows.
Oh, it was a great night.
How about this?
It was so funny.
Really? Story. I'm on that too, talking about my father. Because he killed my father when I was 10. But I got to talk about it. I got to talk about my father, and I knew my father. So for everything he did, doesn't make me not cage my father.
Mm-hmm.
What else? I'm on a lot of things, which is good. I'm not America's Most Wanted, that's most important.
He was.
Oh, yeah.
But he was a judge. He played.
Thanks.
The actor.
What episode was that? Were they after?
It was last year. Colorado. Colorado. Spilled it for water.
Pedophile guy.
You convicted him?
Huh? They got him, actually. The only thing that ended up on the TV from him was his hand and didn't like that.
They're so cheap.
Did they get your voice on there?
I understand that, because I was on one episode of Sopranos.
They ran out of time in the second episode. They ran out of time and they
That's what killed me.
Show was well made.
The one episode of Sopranos, they filmed and filmed and filmed. It was supposed to be in Miami, but we were in New Jersey in a strip club. That's where they were filming us. And they filmed the film, I was like, yes, I'm all in my mind. All you saw me is one take, one bite. Everything I said.
We were just hoping he was on the plane. We're like, oh my gosh, did something happen? Right? Well, we knew he was, but you start thinking.
The facility.
Everybody at the airport was thinking.
If they picked him up, they wouldn't be allowed to for a trip.
That's what I thought. That's what we were thinking, but that's why we were like, well, can I pick him up? Can we, make it? Because he knows he can't get away with it.
Once he's accepted there, He's with them now, so he's under their insurance. I can pick him up because I'm an employee of there.
Okay.
As well as consultant for there. But they employed me there because I do pick people up, but I do tell them about them. They come for me.
Right.
I let them know I'm watching out for them.
So appreciate it. They both need it. They both needed to see each other. Especially Brian Brown's work, he's doing it totally.
He said he's never been away before. So he's going to be very surprised at the treatment he's going to be getting right now. Best. The best. It's behavioral health is the best place. And that's why I send people there. Because they get better. She's having a hard time feeling.
He doesn't like to feel. When he was down here, he didn't have real access to too much. You know, because he was my shadow and I didn't have any. He would stay with me. He was good. And we got him talking and I got him started and then we got him into therapy in New York. And that's why we sent him in. It's stressful. He's been taking care of his father for a while and trying to help, but then escaped from it, kind of, dealt with what he was doing. It'll be okay.
And he's going to be able to deal with a lot in the right setting.
And that's what we're, that's why I was
working
for this.
He's close by.
I said, because we're, it's beyond us.
That's great.
He needs to go talk and be with people who don't, you know, who are on the outside, that he can say whatever he wants to, not us.
Right. Yeah, we'd be amazed at what people keep inside. Right.
And I'm sure he's going to do a lot. Mm. I'm sure there's a lot of him. Yeah. And he just needs to go and talk. And like being at home with Allison's therapist, it's hard, you know, because it's his mother's therapist.
No, therapy is therapy. But specialized therapy in addiction is so important for a foundation for him.
He was saying that that's what's going to help.
He's with people, where he's going to hear people talk that sound like him.
And that's what he needs.
And a lot of everyone's going through, you know, different variations of the same thing. You know.
He thinks he's by himself.
Right.
He's not alone. He'll find out he's not alone.
That's the happiest moment.
Yeah, that's a big breakthrough.
I know when he's back on because he doesn't call me. He doesn't talk to me.
Right.
Know, usually, like before, he was texting me every 10 minutes. I would get texts. And, hey, we're still waiting. And like he's always checking in with me or whatever. And then all of a sudden he stopped calling me when he went home and I knew.
Did you get the paper from Christine? I mean, from Behab? Did they fax it to you, email it to you? They did.
Yeah, my brother just
because he was panicking. He goes, why got on there? I forgot to give the email address. I go, Aunt doesn't get it. She knows the call for Steven.
I texted her. Yeah, no. I know he's got very bad anxiety.
And Christina can't wait to come and go eat.
I know. I told her I already did that because she really was great. She really helped me out and made it easier. So.
No. When she comes down, we'll all go out for dinner and I'll buy you dinner. Oh, yeah. Because I go to the station house on that down. I had the 9-pound lobster there. It was bigger than my head. The claws were bigger than my head.
Right.
Yeah.
Then somebody took me to the Grumpy Grouper. It was, like you have to be hometown to know what that is. So somebody from hometown was down at a Grumpy Grouper. Because I would have drove past there a million times, never stopped. I walked in and said, wow. I was worried that you weren't going to be here, it was too late.
Because this and that is very important to me. Me too, but I'm just, these two, and he doesn't want to do anything. You know, like I'm very open, and what's going on with him, I want her to see. She needs to know and see. Because when I lived in New York, when I lived in Staten Island, he lived with me for 2.5 years with my brother. My brother moved in when he passed and he got divorced and stuff. And he moved in. And the kid practically was... So it's her brother. It's not even a cousin. It's not... you know, they're buddies through and through. She didn't miss seeing him.
I fell asleep. I was so upset. I was like, you make sure I'm up. And she's like, if you're sleeping, I don't really want to wake you up. I was like, no, you're going to wake me up.
No,
you're going to wake me up.
And then we'll give him some strength. That's all. Give him some strength. Because he's not.
Sure. He's in a battle. Where is the cancer?
He had rectal cancer. They operated him. And they took it out, but they only could get like maybe 99%. It spread to his sacrum bone, and he's on colostomy now,
right,
and stuff. But it spread to the sacrum, and they're waiting. He had half his foot amputated from the diabetes, so they're trying to figure out if they can do the radiation. He also has a sore on the back that's not healing, and that's where they got to do the radiation, so they don't know if they can do it because it'll make that worse. There's a lot of factors going on there. He doesn't heal because of the diabetes. He's not healing so hot. But they also had him dead. He's been in a coma, my brother, 5 times in the past 2 years, and where they've always been that we've been told 5 organs are gone, he's going to die. Come. And then he wakes up and he's fine. Like this.
Sometimes I think they don't know. That's what I think.
You never know. And that's a game, you know, like it's hard to watch and see him in the comas and stuff. And Ryan, you know, was the one up there, and that's why being down here, you know, I get to help by as best I can. But you don't know what tomorrow is with him. You know, my brother doesn't know that the doctors are arguing about the 6 month thing. He doesn't know that. He fired the doctor who said 6 months. He just fired him. But he doesn't know why he fired him. He just fired him. He got pissed off and fired him. But the oncologist, who is the important one, in our opinion, he says that that the cancer is not what's going to kill him. But these two are two peas in a pod. You got cancer, you're dying, but yet you continue to smoke cigarettes. You continue to put crap in your body that you shouldn't be. And he'll answer you, well, I don't blow smoke.
Yeah, well, good answer.
He's got an answer for it.
Always. Oh, these two. They have two pieces of mind.
That's why we're glad we got him here.
Thank you. You know now. And it'll help my brother to feel, you know, stronger also, to see him and stuff.
Yeah, especially since he's going, where he's going.
Yeah. Yeah. He doesn't have to worry.
Right.
We're trying, what's he doing, you know, is he okay, is he alive today? There's been a couple of times that we didn't know, you know, Ryan called me, and he wasn't in good shape, of course, and he's not in good shape, and we're like, we're all the way here, what are we going to do?
Just let me know what's going on. If you need to bring him again, I'll bring him. I'll get a pass if he needs to come. I'll bring him myself.
Hopefully, Jimmy,
you can bring
him. Hopefully, my brother will.
Well, he's going to come.
Well, miracles happen.
Okay.
Every day.
That's why he was down.
God needed her.
She decided she needed to die before my brother. She needed to be there. To
I see. Parents, those children. It's a disease of addiction.
also believe that Ryan finally decided to do this because she pushed, or she's got something to do with it. I do believe that.
He wants to continue living the way he's living, but I think he knows how fast it gets bad.
I agree with
you. It gets worse faster as we go. He said he had 7 months, and then a month, and then a month, he went bad. And I just had the kid before. The third time I picked him up at the airport. The first time I was in his room, explaining to him where he was going, doing intervention. Second time he called me, and this time he called me again. I said, how fast? That.
Yeah. Well, Leo at this time said, go away, go. And that's what I said to him. I said, go talk, go be with people who aren't us, who aren't your mom, who aren't your brothers, who aren't your father. You need to be with others that hear it differently than we all do.
And they're not emotionally attached to them.
I said, you have to go and just, you know, so hopefully,
especially with how skinny his arms get, he's got no muscles in there.
Yeah, do you see how thin he got now?
He said, you told me his arms like, you're like me.
Do you see how thin he was?
That eagle was just on the face at one time.
You know what it was? I only had this middle thing, and it looked so small, my arms were big. So I had the wings there. And now it's
see that. It still looks good, though. Hey, that
why don't you go like this and see if it flaps?
And then James is like, I wait 20. There's no way you wait 20. I said, they just weighed me yesterday. 348 to 220.
And it's all mostly water. It was just water.
Water retention. I told you, we're gonna call, make sure we can, tell the property, we're gonna have a pass, we can come, and I'll find out where family is.
Yes.
Then we can do the family visit.
Okay.
All right.
Yes.
Even if I might be able to get out.
Yeah, I could probably take him out.
Yeah.
We could probably
take him out. Okay. You can't sit on this.
All right.
Well, thank you. He's in a good place. He's close by.
Yeah, I know. I'm surprised.
Yeah, that's a blessing, really.
Yes, it's a blessing.
And it's an awesome place.
I'm He's trying to, he almost got out this way. Turned himself sideways.
Did he?
And almost made it through.
Yeah, I love watching turtles.
Only happens when turtles. Everything from one cheese.
Yeah.
was watching a thing on the animal channel. Yeah, let's go.